password update without re-encrypting? How is that even possible? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. How is it possible that you can change your Windows password without re-encrypting a hard disk that was encrypted using that password? I'm going to assume that the question is referring to BitLocker. And indeed, you can change your login password, your Microsoft account password, and one would think that might require that your entire hard disk that has been encrypted with the old password now needs to be re-encrypted using the new one. It doesn't. And the secret is, your password wasn't used to encrypt the hard disk. Now, before you panic, let me explain what's going on. To begin with, this is high level, and it actually applies to other systems besides BitLocker or other kinds of encryption systems. Like I said, this is very high level. I don't mean to imply that this is exactly how BitLocker works, but conceptually, this is how many encryption tools actually work. When you first encrypt data, the actual encryption key is generated for you. That encryption key is typically a 128-bit, 256-bit, maybe a 1024-bit number. It's generated for you because it's very large. It's something that is very random, much more random than you and I can generally generate on our own. That is the key, the encryption key that is used to actually encrypt your data. Okay, where does your password come in? Well, actually, that part's pretty simple. Your password is used to encrypt the encryption key. Your data is unaffected because the encryption key actually doesn't change. That's what's used to encrypt your data. But your password is then used to separately encrypt the quote-unquote real encryption key. That way, when you change your password, all that has to happen is the encryption key needs to be decrypted using your old password and then re-encrypted using your new password. The data continues to be encrypted using that same key. And this is one of the reasons that, especially with tools like BitLocker, it's so important to actually save your recovery key. These are the kinds of things that, independent of your password, are the encryption keys and information that can be used to decrypt your data. Now, like I said, other programs may do this very similarly. A lot of password vaults, for example, will do this. You can change your password vault master password, but it may not necessarily require that your entire vault be re-encrypted because your entire vault was encrypted using a much more secure random number. So, what if you want to force the re-encryption? Well, I can't speak to the password vaults. It varies depending on what's going on. I know that with LastPass, for example, when they had you increase the number of cycles that was used to generate the random number, by definition, they were re-encrypting your entire database. They're changing how that random number is generated. For BitLocker, I'm actually not aware of a way to actually force a re-encryption other than manually decrypting the data and then re-encrypting the data. That way, when you re-encrypt, you are generating a brand new, completely random number that is used as the encryption key, which is then secured using your password. So, the bottom line, choose good passwords and passphrases, absolutely, but don't be afraid if changing a password seems too easy. Your data is still secure, and secure in a very common and probably much more secure way than you might realize. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/75685. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.